Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Today I am thankful to the Help Library to give me a chance to elaborate on the subject of homeopathy for respiratory disorders. Now, why do we get respiration problems often? Is it viral infection or is it the tendency of the body to catch cold because our immunity power is low? And who catches cold? Children from 6 days of age to 90 years of age, everyone catch cold. What is the reason to catch cold? Is it weak immunity power? Yes. Is it tendency to catch cold? Yes. Is it viral infection? Question mark. How can you improve upon it? Is it the weather change? Yes. Is it the food that you eat? Yes. All the factors that I have mentioned just now, weather change from winter to summer, from summer to rainy season, from rainy season to winter, all are responsible for having cold, tendency to cold, whose immunity power is weak. What do you mean by respiratory problems? By respiratory problem, we mean running nose or catching cold or tonsillitis or bronchitis. Bronchitis means inflammation of the bronchial tubes, or asthmatic bronchitis. Now, basically, what will you do to improve your immune system? Whose immunity power is very less? In acute conditions, will homeopathy help or not for the respiration problems? Will allopathy overcome homeopathy, or is homeopathy better in the long run? Whenever there is an acute problem of respiration, for example, running nose, if you take allopathy, in 2 days you will become all right, but the problem will reoccur again whenever the cause will be there. So the tendency to catch cold from the body does not leave you permanently. The problem remains to catch cold. So to remove the cause permanently that will affect your body, it is important that you take homeopathy when acute problem is there, and when no problem is there also you continue to take medicines, something called miasmatic remedies, by which the immunity power of the body will increase. When the immunity power will increase, the tendency to catch cold will become less and less. What do you mean by tendency to catch cold will become less? That means you will not catch cold every 15 days or every 1 month. Sorry. As you used to catch, and it will not be there for 4-5 days, but it may be there for 2 days. Slowly, slowly the tendency to catch cold will reduce and the cold will go away. Now, my dear friends, when the topic today is homeopathy for respiration problems, when the discharge comes from the nose, it could be watery, it could be yellow, it could be green. For watery discharge, we have different medicines. For green, we have different medicines. For yellow, we have different medicines. For the type of discharge, and for the causation we have different medicines. So to make you write the name of the medicines would be foolish according to me, because suppose the discharge is different and you understand it differently, then the medicines will not help you. In cases of cold, rhinitis, that is watery discharge from the nose, you need to see whether the nostrils are red or not. You need to see whether the throat is red or not. in many cases when the throat is not red and your stomach is bad, you may eat spicy food and oily food or junk food and you may get a wheezing attack. A wheezing attack means you may go into asthmatic bronchitis. So your stomach is bad and you are getting an asthmatic bronchitis. So in these cases you need to understand the body has to be treated as a whole. The local part has not to be treated. You have to see that the cause of bronchitis, that means inflammation of the bronchi, and the cause of asthmatic bronchitis, is it the stomach origin or is it the weather origin or is it cold drinks origin or is it due to weak immunity? Once you study yourself, your body, then you will know the reason. According to the reason and according to the symptoms during the acute problem, medicines are given and the problem can be removed from the root cause. Medicines that are constitutional in nature are given up to CM potency and the patient can be relieved of cold completely. I will tell you the case of Rohan Gupta, aged 8 years old when he came to me. He had problem of chronic tonsillitis. He had tonsillitis, tonsils which were very big. And he also used to get asthmatic bronchitis and it was due to change of weather, one, and number two, due to eating party food. Party food means wafers, idlis, cakes. Whenever he used to eat this, he used to get asthmatic bronchitis with wheezing. Now, how did I treat this case? When the case came to me, the tonsils were already operated. That means the cold was catching the tonsils. The tonsils were a protective organs for the body so that diseases will not travel inside. But they were only operated. So the disease traveled to the lungs and the child was getting asthmatic bronchitis. When the child was getting asthmatic bronchitis, what was the medicine given to him? The medicine given to him was pulsatilla. Pulsatilla was for party food. Other medicine given to him was Ipecac. Ipecac was due to wheezing, cough. Antim Tart due to rattling cough. And Hipparsulf for change of weather. So this combination of three medicines was given in 30 potency. Hipparsulf, Antim Tart, Bryonia and Pulsatilla. All in 30 potency, twice a day or four times a day, depending upon the tendency to cough, or every 2 to 2 hourly so that the wheezing will reduce. And to take hot water when you drink, hot water with honey, so that the rattling cough will become less. The patient improved remarkably within 2 to 3 days. Then again, the patient used to have in between cough and cold continuously, but it used to be due to change of weather where Hipparsulf and Bryonia used to be given because the cough was dry in origin. And then the miasmatic medicine that was given to him was tuberculinum because he had tendency to tuberculosis. In the past, he had tuberculosis of the lungs when he was very small. He was given anti-tubercular medicines for 6 months with empty test positive. So, now, if you see this patient, he took about 6 months to be completely cured. Tendency to cold and cough kept on coming, but at the end of the sixth month was a month where there was actually no cold and cough at all. And he used to be given medicines to improve his digestion. That will, he had a weak digestion, so the acid from the stomach used to travel to the lungs and so he used to get dizzy.
So his digestion would improve, he would not get cold and cough. And tendency to cold was reduced by giving medicines to improve the immunity of the body. And constitutional medicines were given. So to make you write all these medicines is difficult, viewers. So please bear with me. I will give you some of the common medicines that are used. So this patient, this child of 8 years was better within 6 months, in which tendency to catch cold, change of weather, constitutional medicines, miasmatic medicines, all were used by which he was completely better within 6 months. There are patients you must have seen who are having asthmatic bronchitis for years together, or they get only in winter season, or they get only when they eat outside food, or they get asthmatic bronchitis only with emotional disturbance, or they get asthmatic bronchitis only when they hear some bad news, or with outside food they get, or with change of weather they get. Now asthmatic bronchitis, when it is with change of weather, mostly Hipparsulf is used. When it is due to stomach origin means when you eat outside food and you get, medicines used are Pulsatilla, Bryonia and Nux Vomica. Any of the three are used. It is not that all the three are used. Any of the three are used. Then asthmatic bronchitis, if you get with bad news, Ignatia, or with chronic psychological problem, Natrum Moor. Then asthmatic bronchitis, if you get in summer, or asthmatic bronchitis if you get in winter, or if you catch a cough first, Spongia. If you have greenish discharge, Pulsatilla, Merxol. Many other drugs are there, but I would not go in, like to go in details. Greenish discharge, watery discharge, you can say arsenic alm, ileum sepa, still many other drugs are there, but these are the common drugs. Arsenic alm and ileum sepa. Now, what is important is that if you have tendency to cold, the question is, should I stop taking cold drinks? What should I avoid? You must avoid taking milk in the evening after 7, you must avoid taking rice in the night. You must stop completely outside food and stop taking cold drinks like thumbs up, 7s up, 7 up and all. You have to stop it completely. You can take fruits by which the immunity power can increase, and take salads which are steamed by which the immunity power will increase, and all the vegetables and fruits have to be washed with salt water so that the effect of pesticides will not come to us, because all the food are grown with the help of pesticides. And everything contains pesticides, so washing it properly is very important and hygienic. It is also very important that the person who is making food, his mood has to be completely alright. Now we were speaking on to tendency to cold. Whenever there is tendency to cold, it is better to stop cold drinks for a span of 3 months or 6 months. So whenever you are under medication, then slowly we can start the cold also and see that the effect of cold will not be there on the body and the patient is completely alright. Now cases who are having asthmatic bronchitis, especially when there is change of weather. With every change of weather, they have asthmatic bronchitis. They take up a certain position to sit, like this bend forward, or they sit with a pillow at the backside, or they are better doing like this, or they are better sitting in the open air. So whenever they are better in sitting in a certain position, there are few medicines that will come when they are better in sitting in a certain position. If they are better while sitting in open air, a few medicines will come which will help them to be completely better or to remove the acute attack. The question is that during an asthmatic attack, can homeopathic medicines be given or allopathic pump has to be taken? If the problem is intolerable, you can use allopathic medicines. It will depend upon the severity of the problem and the approach of the patient to himself. I cannot say that you must take allopathic or you must take homeopathic during acute asthmatic attack. It will depend upon the severity of the problem plus the constitution of the patient. But I would definitely say in between two attacks, if homeopathic medicines are taken, the immunity power will improve, the constitution will improve, and the habitat of the patient due to what he gets the problem, that can be improved by knowing the history of the patient. For example, he is getting asthmatic bronchitis by eating outside food or by irregular habits or by smoking. So if we give homeopathic medicines for irregular food or eating outside food, we give medicines on that to improve digestion, definitely second time he will eat outside food, he will get asthma, but the intensity will be less. If the asthmatic attack will continue for 1 hour, instead of 1 hour, it will continue for 45 minutes or for 30 minutes. And slowly, slowly the intensity will improve and the number of times asthmatic attack will come will also keep on reducing. And the patient will be completely better within a year's time. At least, suppose you are having asthma since for 10 or 15 years. Then it may take about 7-8 months with homeopathic medicines to be completely better. But definitely you will be better. There have been ample of patients who with patience take medicine and are fully cured. And even when the same problem comes, like there is change of weather or they are eating outside food, they do not catch asthma again. And they are so happy. It is because the digestion is improved, the immunity level is improved, and their awareness of why the problem is happening, they start looking into themselves of why the problem is happening. The sad part is that the patients are not aware of why the problem happens to them. They never also look into themselves of why the problem is happening. Only when they are questioned and they are asked to look into everything and they are given on a written paper the probabilities of what question of what can cause them a problem, then they will look into themselves and let us know about the problem, that is about the causative factor that is causing the problem. Then accordingly we can give the medication, because homeopathic is totally dependent upon symptoms presentation during acute case, during chronic case, and in between when the patient is better, to give miasmatic medicines or constitutional medicines by which the immunity power of the patient will improve and the patient can be completely alright. Now, if you go to see, if a patient gets fever during an acute problem, should you treat fever? That the patient's fever should go. What is fever? Fever is the outcome of heat in the body. So when there is fever, you must wipe the body with cold water. When you wipe the body with cold water, what happens is the temperature exchange will take place between cold and hot, and the hot will become cold. And that is why there is no need to give crocin also. You just give cold water fermentation and the temperature will go away even if it is 102. So during fever, and there are biochemic medicines which are available, by like biochemic compound number 11. That is used for fever for small children. Then biochemic compound number 6, which is used for cold for small children. This is what I am talking from about 6 days to 4 years. You can use this biochemic medicines, about 5 pills or about 2 pills, ranging from 2 pills to 5 pills depending upon the age, to be given twice a day. DD means twice a day. This can be put in water and given. Put 20 pills in a glass of water and give that water every day, a full day, so the fever can go down. This is regarding cold. Then for stomach upset, we have biochemic number 25. 11 number we have, for many cases have got diarrhea along with cold, small children. 11 number is there for diarrhea. Biochemic compound number 11. 25 is for indigestion. Could be used for indigestion for children or for infants. These are the common medicines which are being used, because as soon as the child is born, small children are full of cold. They get wheezing, they get redness of the anus, they get green watery discharge or yellow discharge. Along with cold, there is also diarrhea. So we are pumping in medication to stop the diarrhea or to stop the cold. But if there is dirt in the body, it is better if it is expelled, or if it is better it is closed down. Please tell me the answer.
It has to be expelled.
It has to be expelled. So if the cold that is there, which is unwanted discharge, if you are having diarrhea, is it good or bad? Diarrhea, if you are having, if it is many times by which you get weakness or there is dehydration, it's a different matter. But little diarrhea many a times settles on its own. The body throws out that is junk, that it cannot be kept in the body. So you must understand that the body requires to balance itself. So what cannot be taken by the body is thrown out in the form of diarrhea, in the form of cold, in the form of cough. So if a patient is coughing many times, we must understand that there is bulgum in the body. You must not complain that there is cough. The tendency to cold has to reduce, and the causation has to reduce rather than the cough to be treated. You have to see at the cause of the problem, but not the problem, the symptom. But when we look at the patient, we look at the color of the sputum, the type of cough, the time it comes, before food, after food, yellow color, green color, and is it connected, after cough is there vomiting or not. If along with cough there is vomiting, Cupramate is given. Along with cough, if there is, the cough is better by drinking water, another medicine is given. So important particular symptoms are to be seen, and then tendency to catch cold has to be seen. Antipsychotic medicines that are used for in homeopathy are very important, like thuja. We use thuja to remove the tendency of cold from the body, but it cannot be used. It's a danger signal. You cannot use tuberculum, clinum and thuja on your own without the help of a doctor. Many other medicines if you take, it's fine. But tuberculum and thuja, without the consultation of the doctor, they can never be used. And medicines for small infants are in 30 power. And medicines for elderly patients are in 200 power. About in acute symptoms, we use 30 power for children. Now, many a times what is happening that the constitution of the patient wherever digestion is weak is because the children have a habit of eating outside food, yes or no?
True.
And the tendency to the food habits require to be changed at that level. It is not. And whenever your constitution is weak but still you keep on eating. A patient came to me that with cold and cough and with bronchitis, asthmatic attack, they get acidity. But they said that whenever I eat food, I must eat spicy food. Now, can you tell me if spicy food is not being controlled and we are giving medicine for bronchitis or asthmatic bronchitis, what is the meaning? As soon as the spicy food was controlled, acidity went and cough was better. So, the cough was connected to digestion and the positive factor had to be stopped. Then I had to give medicine for spicy food. Capsicum is used for spicy food. And medicines to be given that cough relieved by cold water, phosphorus. Or acidity better by cold milk. But important was that the positive factor had to be stopped, then positive factor medicine had to be given, and then the patient was made completely alright. I hope the explanation is quite okay. Yeah. Yes or no?
Yeah, true.
Are you understanding the concept of respiratory problems?
Yeah.
That why and how the respiratory problems come? Now it is this respiratory problems that in future. How much time we have, madam?
You can take.
10 minutes?
10-20 minutes you can take.
It is these respiratory problems in future, for example, tendency to cough. You must have seen, this is off the point I am talking, but when there is tendency to bulgum in the body, in the blood, thrombus can be formed, clot can be formed, and our body is made of vat, pitta and cough. If there is more cough in the body, the cough can travel into the blood and a clot can be formed. And it can go to the brain also, and lack of circulation can happen in certain part, and paralysis can happen and cerebrovascular attack can also happen. So what is important is that tendency to clot formation, tendency to hemorrhage. Hemorrhage happens when there is more heat in the body. When does hemorrhage happen? When there is more heat in the body. And when there is more heat in the body, even cough can come. Patient, I told you one patient just now of acidity was having asthmatic bronchitis. In that case, the acidity had to be treated by which the cough would become better. Because what happens if there is constant heat to the small tubes that are there, like arteries and veins and nerves? The small arteries and veins that are so delicate rupture, and then there is hemorrhage. So it is no fault of ours. We have not been able to recognize. हमने हमारे शरीर के स्वभाव से पहचान नहीं बनाई है. इसीलिए हमको तकलीफ हो रही है. और ये पहचान कैसे बनाने की किसी ने हमको रीत सिखाई नहीं है. किसी नोटबुक में इसकी रीति नहीं लिखी है. इसीलिए हमको तकलीफ हो रही है. इसमें किसी का दोष नहीं है. दोष हमारा ही है. द मिनट यू रिकॉग्नाइज टू बी फ्रेंडली विथ योर बॉडी एंड द मिनट यू रिकॉग्नाइज टू द मिनट यू रिकॉग्नाइज टू रिस्पेक्ट योर बॉडी और टू उसको पहचानने का आप रिकॉग्नाइज करोगे तो अपने आप सिम्टम्स बॉडी के चेंज हो जाएंगे बिकॉज यू विल चेंज योर मेथड एंड योर स्टाइल ऑफ लिविंग. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड? फॉर एग्जाम्पल दैट लेडी यूज टू गेट कॉफ ड्यू टू ईटिंग स्पाइसी फूड एंड पुटिंग मिर्ची इन द फूड बट शी स्टॉप स्पाइसी फूड एंड हर कॉफ स्टॉप. If I am eating pizza and if I am eating dahi vada and I am getting a cough, but still I keep on eating pizza and dahi vada and still the cough keeps on coming, is it the fault of the doctor or is it the fault of the patient? If you go to the allopathic doctor, he will keep on giving you allopathic medication for the same. He will say continue for 7 days. You will continue, you will become better, you will continue with pizza and this. But if you go to a homeopathic doctor, the homeopathic doctor will look, oh, your stomach is bad, so please stop this and this. And I'm giving you medication for weak digestion. Then second time he will give you medicines for weak digestion when you are symptom free. And again he will ask you to take pizza or dahi vada and tell you that you see whether you are getting cold and cough or not. So it is important to understand that you as a whole, why you are getting problem, how you are getting problem and what remedy can be used by you yourself to stop the problem. If you are getting cough, you can take hot water with honey. You can put haldi in hot water and drink that water. You can take, stop taking milk, or you can take milk with gur and haldi. That is also a known remedy which you all know, age old remedy for cough. Do you all have any questions to ask? Any questions to ask, please? Because otherwise I will continue to...
Haldi with milk with haldi?
Milk with haldi with gur. That will help to reduce the cough, the intensity of the cough. I know a gentleman who is having continuously cough. Once he was asked to do bronchoscopy. Bronchoscopy means to find out the reason of cough, they put a scopy inside. Scopy is to look into the bronchial tubes. What is the cause of cough? But then when I told the patient, when I told the ENT doctor that the patient is better by taking Himcocid or anti-acidity medicine, they decided not to do bronchoscopy because in bronchoscopy nothing will be found. That patient still continues with cough because eats spicy food. The digestion is weak. That patient has not followed the instruction to take homeopathic medication but still is juggling with digestion and still cough remains. Cough comes like whooping cough. Medicine to be given at that time is Cupramed. And due to bad stomach, Pulsatilla and Nux Vomica will come. So when Pulsatilla, Nux Vomica and Cupramed will be given together, the cough will become better. And then medicines for digestion improvement are given. Then the patient will improve because the patient has history of chronic constipation. Does not pass through for 8 days if the patient will not take any laxative every day. Laxative means some churan or some Dulcolax or anything. So it is very important to understand that you need to regularize your life, respect your body and take all medications regularly at a given time. For your question will be, can we take allopathic when homeopathic medicines are going on? Yes, you can take allopathic if the intensity of the symptoms are more and if you are not very and if you don't have faith in homeopathy, then you can stop for a day or two. Keep 1 or 2 days blank and again start with homeopathic. Because in homeopathic medicines are so good in except surgery, cardiac surgery, TB and cancer and viral infections, homeopathy will not work. Otherwise, for all other medicines, homeopathy will work. For cancer also, homeopathic medicines can be given. See, because homeopathy will help a lot. It is not that you have to take homeopathy for a longer time. When acute problems are there, or allopathic requires to be taken every time. It is proportional to the doctor who gives the medicine and proportional to the intensity of faith that you have that the results will be produced. Because nothing is impossible. If you take medicines properly and regularly, asthmatic bronchitis, tendency to cold, all can be treated. 30 years cold can be treated within a year or so. Asthmatic bronchitis can be treated. When I used to write articles for newspapers of Bombay Samachar, I used to write articles and articles whereby we used to see small children from the school having tendency to cold due to change of weather and greenish discharge, or cold due to exams. So gelsemium will come in that. So colds used to take due to cold drinks. They are feeling hot, they will go to the canteen and drink Sprite. And then go for running race also, if sports day is there. So children with cold drinks, with outside food, very common. And medicines that Pulsatilla, Naxomica, Arsenic, Antimicrobial. This is for weak digestion that we commonly use. Pulsatilla, Antimicrobial, Arsenic for weak digestion, and asthma is there. So whenever asthma, or even if you are getting a cold due to weak digestion, cold means what will happen? You will start having bulgum and you will vomit after cough. Many children have a tendency to vomit after cough, after they eat outside food. So they think that patient is having cold, cough. But it is because of outside food that they are developing irritation in the throat and the cough is coming. So you need to understand the causation of cough. So in everything, what is important? Causation. Symptoms. Acute or chronic. And for all cases of cold, this medicine combination will always help. Arsenic, Hipparsulf, Nux Vomica. All in 30 power, if you take for 15 days, there is no side effect. Arsenic, Hipparsulf, Nux Vomica. Arsenic is for digestion also, for cold also. Nux Vomica is for digestion, for irregular diet. Hipparsulf is for change of weather. If you give small children also, or even if adults take, there is no side effect at all. It will always help the patients. Any questions you want to ask? Otherwise I will keep on talking.
Yes sir, thank you.
You want to ask any questions?
No, but I want to ask you, when the digestive system improves according to the homeopathy, in that case laxatives and other things are to be avoided, or yet they have to go? Because the digestion is good, then the constipation will naturally be reduced.
Why does the constipation come, first of all? Constipation comes due to excess of heat in the body.
Okay.
Now when excess of heat is there in the body, what will you do? You have to give alkali food. Now what is alkali food? You have to stop using oil. You have to use ghee. You have to take more green leafy vegetables. You have to take more sprouted food and take steamed food. You have to take more fruits. Stop oranges and strawberry. So, and take more hot vegetable soups, mixed vegetable soups. Take milk with ghee, with sugar, or with honey for constipation in the night.
Mm-hmm.
Now it is, we are coming to constipation, then we are coming to heat.
Okay.
From heat we are coming to alkali food. Did you see how
yes.
you are going? It is a vicious circle whereby you need to recognize your whole body, that why, what is happening. And only when you recognize why, what it is happening, then you can give treatment. For constipation, taking laxative is not the answer. It is to change the constitution of the inner lining of the stomach. You need to understand that why the problem is there. And is having constipation bad digestion? No. What is weak digestion? That as soon as you eat outside food, you will vomit, or you will develop cough, or you will get diarrhea, or in 2 days you will not get constipation. When you are eating heavy food out from outside. So it is all this food that requires to be kept in control. Or even if you are having outside food, if you have in limitation, for example, tea causes acidity, but after tea if you drink hot water, what will happen? Acidity will not come in the stomach lining, in the throat lining. In that way, if you do little tricks, that if you are eating heavy food, then you drink water upon it, the food will not stick into the lining and it will not cause a problem. So you require to look into the problem and decide the precautionary measure what is to be taken. One very important thing, that if homeopathic medication is taken before a person gets married and has tendency to cold, the cold will be prevented in the new generation.
Mm-hmm.
Did you understand?
Yes. Very important.
So you can prevent cold, you can prevent high BP, you can prevent diabetes mellitus, you can prevent cancer, you can prevent TB.
Okay.
Everything can be prevented by taking medication before marriage or before conceiving. If you know that you are having this tendency, you will not give it to your next generation. Because what you give your generation is money, your bad swabhav, and your diseases. Nothing else you give your child. In gift you will give money, you will give your nature, and you will give your diseases. The child will say, I got this diseases because of heredity. So to stop diseases, homeopathic is a way. To stop swabhav, satsang is the way. To transfer money is always going to be there. But again there could be some problem. So I hope we will end this. Can we end the lecture now? Time
yeah,
is over.
Yeah, very good. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much.